This figure shows the implementation of a parallel FIR filter with constant coefficients. The output of an FIR filter of order L is calculated using the convolution sum, as given by this equation. An FIR filter consists of a series of tapped delay lines, adders, and multipliers. The FIR coefficients, also known as tap weights, determine the filter's response. Typically, the adders are implemented in multiple pipeline stages to improve the timing performance of the filter. In the VHDL code, we will closely follow this graphical representation of the FIR filter. The proposed filter operates efficiently with integer values. The VHDL entity defines a 16-bit input, and after filtering, due to multiple stages of multiplication and addition, the output signal is expanded to 32 bits. In the VHDL code, each stage processes delayed samples and passes the results to the next stage. At each stage, the data bit width changes depending on the applied operations. To handle this, we need separate arrays to store the data for each stage. Here, we define the array types required to hold the intermediate data across stages. The code allows you to design your FIR taps using Python or MATLAB and then easily copy the coefficients into the VHDL code. The filter consists of 32 taps, each with an 11-bit width. You will need to quantize your FIR coefficients to 11 bits before using them in the VHDL implementation. Different processes in the design handle specific tasks with the help of defined arrays. The first process is the delay line, which shifts input samples through the buffer. Each new input pushes the existing samples one stage forward. Multiply stage. Each delayed sample is multiplied by its corresponding coefficient, producing 32 parallel product values for summation. Accumulating stage. To compute the final output, all product values must be accumulated. However, the summation is performed across multiple stages to enhance pipelining and improve system timing, with sufficient registers inserted between the adders. Generate quantized filter taps with MATLAB. In the provided MATLAB code, you need to configure the following parameters. Sample rate. This is the sampling frequency, which in our design corresponds to the clock frequency driving the system.
Cutoff frequency.
Specify the cutoff frequency for the filter. Number of taps. Set the number of taps for the filter, which determines the filter's precision and performance. In this design, we have 32 taps. Tap bit width. Define the bit width for the filter coefficients, which affects the quantization accuracy. In this design, we need to set it to 11. Filter type. Select the type of filter you need. This code currently supports only high-pass and low-pass filter designs. After running the code will return the quantized taps that you can edit them a bit and use them in your FIR filter. The code also returns the filter frequency response and the filter taps in time domain. Vivado Simulation. Download the two VHDL files from the GitHub repository and add them as new sources to your project. Add a DDS compiler to the block design. In the Configuration tab, set the system clock to 100 MHz. Since we only need to generate sine waves, in the Implementation tab, select the sine option for the output and deselect has phase output options. In the Output Frequency tab, set the frequency for channel 1 to 500 kHz. Add another DDS compiler to the block design. Repeat the same setup, but this time set the output frequency to 10 MHz. Add an adder to the design. Set its input bit width to 8 and its output bit width to 9. Connect the outputs of both DDS compilers to the input of the adder. This will generate the mixed signal. Next, right-click on the block design and add the FIR filter as module to your design. The output of the adder is 9 bits wide, while the FIR filter expects 16-bit signed inputs. To ensure compatibility before feeding the mixed signals into the FIR filter, we need to cast the 9-bit result to a 16-bit signed value. For this purpose, I've provided a casting block that simplifies the conversion process. Just set the input bit width to 9 and the output bit width to 16. Add a simulation clock generator to the design and set its frequency to 100 MHz. This frequency will be also the sample rate of the design. I recommend adding some ports to the design to make it easier to observe the simulation results. Finally, add a top wrapper to your design, and you can run the simulation to observe the behavior. As shown in the simulation results, the first sine wave has a period of 100 nanoseconds, confirming it is a 10 MHz signal. The second sine wave has a period of 2000 nanoseconds, confirming it is a 500 kHz signal. You can also observe the mixed signal, where the faster signal fluctuates in amplitude at the frequency of the slower signal. You'll observe that the FIR filter is behaving as a low-pass filter, attenuating the faster signal, leaving only the desired lower frequency component in the output. In this section, we replace the FIR taps with high-pass filter coefficients. Go to the MATLAB code and configure it to generate quantized high-pass filter taps. Then, copy the generated taps from MATLAB and paste them into the VHDL code. After inserting the new coefficients, Vivado will prompt you to update the IPs, which will refresh the filter module in the block design. Once you run the simulation, you'll see that the FIR filter now functions as a high-pass filter, suppressing the slower signal while preserving the faster one. Vivado implementation. The FIR filter and casting blocks are fully synthesizable, so there's no need to modify them. However, you must provide a clock source for the design. You can use any clock source, such as the PSBL clock from the Zinc IP block, or an external clock generated using the clocking wizard. If you choose to use the Zinc IP block, ensure that the Zinc IP is properly initialized. Otherwise, the PL side will not receive a clock. To keep the process straightforward and avoid using Vitus, I selected to use an external clock available on the evaluation board. The pink Z2 also has an external 125 MHz reference clock connected to pin H16 of the PL. The external reference clock allows the PL to be used independently of the PS. Add a clocking wizard to your design and set its output to 100 MHz. Make the input clock as external. Later on after synthesis, you will need to assign proper pin to the input clock based on your evaluation board setup. Remove all the external pins that we added for the simulation. We need to include an ILA in the design to monitor and study the targeted signals. Add debugging prob for all the ports that you like to study, and then run auto connection. It will add a logic analyzer and connect its inputs to the selected ports. Don't forget to add a top wrapper to your design, and now you can proceed to synthesis. After synthesis completed, open Synthesize Design and navigate to the I/O window. Assign proper pin to the input clock based on your evaluation board schematic. Save the I/O setup as new Vivado constraints, and you can proceed to generate the bitstream. After running the bitstream on device, we should be able to see the same results as simulation,